Good morning, everyone. I'm glad you're here. I'm Mary with Mary Greeley News. Here we have a live view of the Old Faithful webcam. A lot of people staying there or visiting the Old Faithful hotel. There's been continuing events going on at Grant Village, which is over there by the Little West Thumb. Now that is by Yellowstone Lake. Here you can see Yellowstone Lake. And I downloaded two different boreholes. One of the boreholes is from Grant. And it looks like the magma, which is naturally buoyant, wants to rise. The earthquakes and the movement of the magma has been reactivated again of late. Many of you will remember back in 2018 and 2019, there was an earthquake swarm in this location as the magma was creating pressure, rising up, possibly found an area where it was weaker, the earth's crust was weaker, and was trying to erupt in this area. Well, it looks like it's been reactivated again. Now, this is a very deep well that I downloaded the data from. Borehole 944. They're usually about, 500 to 600 feet under the ground, these boreholes, so they don't pick up any outside noise whatsoever. And this is what it was showing when I pulled the file this morning. And, yeah, the redder the color, the more heat that it's putting out. Yeah, it's trying to come up there again. What we've got going on is as the Earth's magnetic field weakens, we're going to have more earthquakes. The continental plates are going to move more. There's going to be more volcanic eruptions, things like that. What we got going on at Yellowstone is tectonic movement along with slow moving tremors. Yeah, lots of slow moving tremors as the plates slowly move. I noticed the other day and yesterday as I was monitoring what was going on, because I do watch what goes on every day. I may not do a report every day. See, this is slow moving tremors, tectonic plate movement. Kind of like what's going on with the quiet tremors up there in Washington, Vancouver, etc. Yeah, and I really haven't ever noticed this before occurring at Yellowstone until this last month. These round areas, that's tectonic movement. And then what's also happening is we got the magma trying to come up. This is harmonic tremors. And we also got, let's take a look here. We also have volcanic tremors going on. See that? Those are volcanic. Let me show you something. This is four different types of earthquakes. We got tectonic. We got shallow volcanic. See how they're long and deep, but slightly rounded at the top. Surface events where it is real quiet and then it gets louder, then it ends up getting quiet again. And then harmonic tremors. Okay, there's the harmonic tremors. They're smaller than the volcanic tremors. Scientists, geologists didn't even know about harmonic tremors until Mount St. Helens went off. And then afterwards they're reviewing what it was doing just before the eruption. Both of these mean that the volcano is recharging for another eruption. Who knows when? Originally, they called these harmonic tremors tornillos, kind of like a corkscrew type of image for the seismic signature. But now they just call them harmonic tremors. When magma or fluid move through the crust, they can produce a seismic signal. Harmonic tremor, unlike normal seismicity related to fault movement, that creates punctuated seismicity, such as a sharp earthquake, a singular event that diminishes with time and then can have aftershocks. The movement of magma or fluids can produce a constant long-period tremor. And see, they got the image down here below. Let me bring this down a little bit. This tremor is also not like most tectonic seismicity, in the sense that it is usually only measurable by seismic instruments. So you can't feel the tremor other than a very rare occurrence if you're within 5 kilometers, about 3 miles, of the volcano. Harmonic tremors were first recognized as a precursor to volcanic activity after the 1985 eruption of a volcano there in Colombia. Harmonic tremors are the type of seismicity that most people associate with an impending or ongoing volcanic eruption. That is, magma movement generates the seismicity. The tremor may precede an eruption by days or hours, or they might not lead to an eruption at all. It would depend on the size of the magma chamber, and in this case, Yellowstone is a super volcano, about 35, 40 miles wide and about 55 miles long. There's been 40 smaller eruptions since its last major eruption. And here we have an image of the magma chamber. I've talked about this before, how it comes up from the mantle, the plume of the earth, the hot point, to the large magma reservoir. And then we've been having a lot of earthquakes in this section right here. And then it rises up as it heats up. Not all rock melts at the same temperature. And kind of moves towards the northeast direction, towards the Sour Creek Resurgent Dome, which is above where Yellowstone Lake is at. And then we got the Mallard Lake Resurgent Dome, and it's got this huge cap of rhyolite, which is holding all that magma that's trying to rise up. So the magma is now rising up and moving horizontally, but every so often it finds an area in the crust of the earth, such as here at Grant, at the Little West Thumb area of Yellowstone Lake, and it tries to push its way up. And that's what we got going on right now, and it's been going on for a while. I've been watching it. I may not have been reporting it, but I have definitely been watching what's going on there. Yeah, school's out. We've been having lots of earthquakes around the world. And, yeah, I'm watching. They're hoping the next eruption will be a small eruption like the last 40 eruptions. Maybe something the size of Mount St. Helens could be, a little bit bigger. And we got this crack here at the bottom of Yellowstone Lake. That's another area where the magma has been trying to come up. And then up over here in yellow, that is the Sour Creek Resurgent Dome. We've had a few earthquakes in this area, the largest being the 4.2, and that was on the 11th of last month. And this is the area that Bob Smith of the University of Utah feels that it will probably erupt, but you just don't know. Now, the other day, I was going to do a report, but I didn't. There was a small swarm of earthquakes down here by Heart Lake. And I took notice of that because this is an area that had earthquakes from its last eruption. The last eruption, Yellowstone did what's called an unzipping. And it started up by the Madison River area, which is up over here. And it did a counterclockwise rotation of earthquakes and lava eruptions. And it came around counterclockwise until it got down to, let's see, where is it again? Right there. To Heart Lake. And that's when both of the resurgent domes, the Mallard Lake Resurgent Dome and the Sour Creek Resurgent Dome, both collapsed at the same time. creating the huge eruption and blowing out the entire area and mountains included. Also up over here near the Madison River area, that was the location of the 7.2 earthquake that they had in 1959. All right. I believe about 12 people were killed during that earthquake. Here we have an image of all the earthquakes that USGS is telling us about. But as you know, they probably only report about 10% of them from the last 30 days. And you can see this line as the plates move, the continent moves. And let's go down over here. Here's the swarm from Heart Lake. And let's go to all the earthquakes within the last week. You can see the Madison River area. Let's see, we got, they're really underestimating them. You know, a 0.2, right? Minus 0.5, a 1.2, a 0.8. Yeah, they lie like a rug. Here we have the borehole for the Madison River area. And we got this one marked in red, which means there was an earthquake that the computers picked up right there. That was a small earthquake, a magnitude 1.84. I'll bring it down. Some of you who are not on your phones could probably see this. Down there at the bottom it says MD 1.84. Now again, this is a borehole, so it's not going to pick up the traffic. It's not going to pick up stampeding buffaloes or anything like that. And then we got, let me make that bigger for you. Oh, we'll just pick a spot. So let's extract that. And here you can see, yeah, we got harmonic and volcanic tremors. And let me bring this over a little bit farther. See how it's round along with tectonic plate movement. We've got some smaller little tremors here. There's one right there. Quick popping of the rock. And there's another teeny tiny one there. And another one there. Looks like that one came from the north. Now, if the first signature is pointing down, means it came, or excuse me, it came from the south. If it's pointing down, it means it came from the south. If it's pointing up, it means it came from the north. A little trick that I learned. And yeah, okay, and let's look some more here. See that little circle in there along with the earthquake? Let's see. Okay, and yeah, we get some drum beats down here, it looks like. Tectonic plate movement, volcanic, and harmonic tremors. Yeah. Let's pull it over. Now again, this is a borehole, so it's only picking up what's going on. And this is the borehole for the Madison River area. Yeah. I also downloaded data from the Sawtooth area. This is the closest monitor I have for there. MCMT. This is not a borehole. It's a regular monitor. And we got one marked in red right there. And I've talked about this. Let's see. That's a small one. And that comes in as a magnitude 1.5. I'll show you where that monitor is at. All right. Right there. Now, this earthquake, they're not reporting. And the reason I'm watching this is because of the fault movement for the Snake River Plateau and the Trans Chalice Fault System that runs all the way up, which has been showing a lot of activity all the way up to Canada, British Columbia. This monitor, too, would probably pick up earthquakes that are happening along the sawtooth fault zone. Up over here, we got Virginia City, Barton Gulch. Let me bring it in a little bit. What else we got up over here? How far is that from Stanley, Idaho? Okay, Stanley is down over here. Okay. So, I believe that's the closest monitor that I have to this area. So anyways, that's why I'm using it. So we got that one, which is a 1.15. We got two more up over here. There's one there. Yeah, see, that's yeah, that is tectonic in movement. Little round little edges on it. Go back and show you up over here. And that's what it, oh, we got. Let me see what this is. Let's pull that. Yeah, see how it's rounded? Yeah. Yeah, the plates are moving. Like I said, it's been increasing around the world, the plate movement, as the Earth's magnetic field weakens. Which just means we're going to start having more earthquakes, larger earthquakes, more volcanic eruptions. Any volcano can erupt within a matter of hours with no warning at all. They are hoping that Yellowstone, when it does decide to erupt, will give them a warning of uplift, which he knows going on, and increase in earthquakes, things like that. Yeah, they're just hoping. Currently, overall, as of March 17th, there was 48 volcanoes in continuing eruption status. And we got an image here of the current erupting volcanoes. I'll give you a link to this. I wish I could make it bigger for you. So that's all I have for you right now. Yeah, always be prepared for disaster. It could be floods, it could be thunderstorms, earthquakes. Yeah, those are increasing. You just don't know, but you should always be prepared for a disaster. War, well, we got the threat of war. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.